Hej, kontynuujemy let's playa z Phase Noir. Ostatnio Jack Del Nero przybył do baru o nazwie Red Tulip, właściwie podbar, no i będzie się chciał napić whisky. Spójrzmy tutaj.
It's an old poster for some dance show. It's an old poster for some dance show. It's called Marzetti's Cats. Greta's name is listed.
I nazwisko Grety, Greta Reed, to jest osoba, która tutaj pracuje w tym barze.
Oh, here's the undaunted detective back from his dangerous mission. How many unfaithful husbands have you discovered tonight?
Wspominałem już wcześniej o dubbingu w kontekście naszego bohatera Jacka Del Nero. Powiedziałem, że początkowo jego głos mnie irytował, ale mimo wszystko no, pasuje on do tej osoby i no, jest całkiem przyzwoicie podłożony. Smiley jest zdecydowanie na przeciwnym biegunie. Brzmi nienaturalnie. Rozumiem, że ta jego barwa głosu i sposób mówienia miały odwzorować osobowość Smiley'a, ale no, zupełnie to nie wyszło. Brzmi to karykaturalnie wręcz.
What do you want, Smiley?
A tough day, detective? But don't get upset. Fortune will look kindly on you sooner or later, just like it did for me today.
What the hell are you talking about?
Smiley had the chance of a lifetime. Goodbye, swindles and fake documents. We're talking about some real cash, cars and the good life.
Why are you so excited tonight?
Smiley is changing his life. No more swindles and fake documents. I've been offered a great job, and I'm going to accept it.
Did you find a free reptile cage at Central Park?
Our detective is always ready with a joke.
What kind of job offer could a snake like you have received?
Oh, sorry, detective, but I can't talk about it.
What kind of dirty business are you mixed up in this time?
Sorry, detective, but we're talking about some serious stuff. And I can't talk about it with anyone, not even you. The only thing I can tell you is that at midnight, Smiley will get a telephone call from one of the most important people in the city.
Yeah, better to not know anything about your business. The recession doesn't seem to affect you, Smiley.
You do what you can. You know, guys like me are always in demand.
Since when have petty crooks been in demand?
Come on, detective. Don't let yourself be fooled by all those naysayers. I'm not as bad as they say.
Smiley, you'd sell your own mother for a couple bucks.
That might be true, detective. But don't be as naive as your old police pals. You know how the world works. I just do my job. If I can help someone in trouble with a few fake stamps and photographs, what's the harm? You aren't going to get all moral on me, telling me that my clients aren't honest people, are you? Everyone has the right to a second chance, and you should know that.
Right. Every respectable murderer should have the chance to create a new identity and commit crimes under a couple of false names.
Detective, you still think of yourself as a policeman. Too bad you were kicked out of that world. I still remember the headlines in the papers. Police scandal.
You'd do well to leave it off there, Smiley.
Don't get upset. We're just chatting.
Of course, chatting. Goodbye, Smiley.
Bye, detective. Goodbye.
Zdecydowanie antypatyczny typ z tego Smiley'a. Sposób, w jaki mówi, raczej sprawia, że no mam wrażenie, że jest lekko opóźniony w rozwoju. To jedna rzecz. Druga rzecz, no po prostu antypatyczny, bo no mówi takie niezbyt ciekawe rzeczy. Po prostu go nie lubię. A teraz porozmawiajmy z Gretą.
Hi, Greta. Pour me a whiskey.
Jack, do you remember that you've had my camera for over a week now? When are you planning to return it?
I actually finished using it tonight. I'll pull out the film roll and it's all yours.
Try not to break it when you pull the roll out. The winder has been broken for years, so you have to do it manually. I suggest you find a dark place when you do it. Otherwise, you can bid farewell to your precious photographs.
Dobrze, to zrobimy to, o co prosi nas Greta i oddamy jej aparat. A ja przy okazji poruszę temat tych wizerunków postaci, wizerunków, sylwetek postaci, które widzimy na zbliżeniach twarzy. Z pewnością postacie, ich twarze nie porażają ilością szczegółów. No, są raczej kiepsko zrobione.
Yes, it's dark enough for me to be able to take the film roll out without any problems.
Będzie to widać zwłaszcza w późniejszym etapie gry, kiedy zobaczymy jedną postać.
Good. I was able to take out the film roll from that damn thing. I hope that the film roll didn't get exposed to too much light. Otherwise, goodbye pictures and goodbye money.
W każdym razie tła wyglądają zdecydowanie lepiej od postaci. To jest pewne i oczywiste. Bo no, tła są klimatyczne. Może też nie są jakieś wielce wyrafinowane, nowoczesne, ale są stworzone ze smakiem, jest w nich zachowany klimat tej epoki, w której rozgrywa się akcja, no natomiast same postacie lepiej pominąć milczeniem. Oddajmy aparat Grecie.
Here's the camera. Can I get my whiskey now?
Whiskey? And how are you going to pay for it? Your account has been overdue for months, Jack. And I have to pay a rent, too. So until you pay, you don't drink.
Am I wrong? Or are you in a bad mood tonight?
Terrible, I'd say.
What happened?
Look around. The joint's empty. There's not a soul except for the one customer I'd happily do without. Smiley. Anyway, I'm busy now and I don't feel like talking.
I have to find a way of getting that sleaze Smiley away from the joint. And I have to do something to make Greta more manageable. Maybe some music might calm her down.
No, akurat Greta wygląda na dość urodziwą kobietę, zresztą też z charakterkiem. Musimy się pozbyć Smileya.
Hi again, detective. What can I do for you?
Smiley, you'd better get out of here.
I don't see why I should, detective.
No i będziemy po raz kolejny łączyć fakty. Ważna rozmowa Smileya, bo Smiley spodziewa się o północy ważnego telefonu. Powiedział nam o tym. I ulewa. Ulewny deszcz zeszłej nocy spowodował wiele awarii. Linie telefoniczne mogą nie działać. O tym przeczytaliśmy w gazecie w hotelu.
Am I wrong, or did you say that you're supposed to get the call that will change your life at around midnight?
Yes. Why are you asking me?
Because tonight the telephone lines may be down in some areas. The storm last night seems to have caused more than the usual damages.
Not a problem. If they can't get through today, they can always get through tomorrow, don't you think?
Certainly. No one would ever give up the chance of working with you just because of a telephone glitch.
Yes, they'll definitely call tomorrow.
You know what, Smiley? They say that real opportunities only come around once.
You think they might change their mind and not call?
I don't know.
Maybe I could go to them, to be on the safe side.
Well, it'd be a shame to throw away the opportunity of your lifetime because of a stupid telephone glitch, right?
Yes, maybe you're right. I better go to them. I'm sorry I have to run. I better hit the road. I have a lot of ground to cover.
Good luck, Smiley.
Thanks, detective. Thanks.
Łatwo z nim poszło.
He might be a dirty snake, but sometimes that guy is as naive as a kid.
No właśnie dla mnie jest taki naiwny jak dziecko, wręcz tak jak powiedziałem, sprawia wrażenie lekko opóźnionego w rozwoju i takiego, któremu no można go przegadać w każdej sytuacji i łatwo oszukać. No, chociaż to, co powiedział Jack Del Nero, że prawdziwa okazja zdarza się tylko raz w życiu, coś też w tym jest.
It's the joint's radio. Maybe Greta will loosen up with a little music.
I niestety łatwo taką okazję przegapić. No ale to już temat na inne opowiadanie, bo teraz musimy zadowolić Gretę. Wstawiamy FM. No i szukamy odpowiedniej częstotliwości.
In a better mood?
Sorry, Jack, but I've had enough. The customers have all disappeared. I'm barely making it to pay my rent. And that slimeball Smiley is here every night. I hate him.
How's the joint going?
Not well.
It looks like you haven't had many customers lately.
Right. It's because of the Great Depression. That's what the papers call it. Banks have gone under, people are unemployed, and there are prostitutes and criminals around every corner of the city. I'd say that the American dream is over, and we're just starting to figure it out.
At least you still have your joint.
I barely make it to the end of the month, and the situation isn't getting any better. Last night, I even closed the joint early. There weren't any customers.
It could be worse. At least you don't spend your nights photographing 20-somethings running around with guys who could be their fathers.
Is that what you were doing tonight?
I'd rather not talk about it.
Mówiąc o wizerunkach postaci, mam też na myśli ruchy ich ust, które są zupełnie niesynchronizowane z wypowiadanymi tekstami. Oczywiście można to tłumaczyć także tym, że gra nie została w oryginale stworzona w języku angielskim, no ale też czasem komicznie to wygląda, kiedy postać mówi jeszcze kilka sekund, rusza ustami jeszcze kilka sekund po tym, jak skończył się tekst, który ona wypowiada.
Why did you pick the name Red Tulip for your joint?
My old man picked it, not me. The joint was his. He opened it after the war. He was in the Air Force. When he got discharged, he got the crazy idea of opening this joint. He was so proud to be Dutch that he decided to call it the Red Tulip, like the flower that represents his country.
What kind of guy was your old man?
He was a good man. I really miss his stories about when he was a pilot in Holland. I was born here in New York. I've never seen Holland, except in books. It must be a beautiful place.
I don't think they're doing too well either right now. How did you end up working in your old man's pub?
One day, my old man got sick and died. I had lost my job as a dancer, so working in his joint seemed like the only thing to do.
So you were a dancer?
Right. The Flying Dutch Girl. That's what they called me. I loved to dance. I was even in a tour in France for an entire year. It was one of the best times of my life, but I guess it was destined to end. With the economic crisis, no one was going to see the shows anymore. Better spend the few bucks left on booze and hookers.
Did you ever try to get back in it?
Didn't make sense anymore. Moreover, now I have to run this joint and serve whiskey to semi-alcoholic former police officers.
Delighted to be part of the story. Let's change the subject. About Smiley.
No, Jack. I don't want to talk about that guy now.
Could I get something to drink?
Your account is overdue, Jack.
Jeszcze może poruszę temat Grety. Jej głos nawet nieźle brzmi. Ma fajną barwę, pasującą do tej postaci. Natomiast nieco brakuje mi emocji, wyrazistości w wypowiadanych kwestiach. Jakiegoś nieco bardziej słyszalnego, lepiej słyszalnego akcentowania. Trochę zbyt mało wyrazisty z jej sposób mówienia.
Tomorrow I'll pay you.
I've heard that story too many times, Jack. It's crap.
I left my money in my other coat.
You don't even have another coat.
Niezła ściema.
Come on, Greta. I spent the entire night out in the rain.
Next time, buy yourself an umbrella.
I hate umbrellas.
Jak stare, dobre małżeństwo.
Sweetheart, I just want one glass.
Don't call me sweetheart, sugar, or any of those names. I hate them.
Maybe you could make an exception for a fan of the Flying Dutch Girl?
It's just a pathetic attempt to flatter me, Jack.
It's worth trying. The worst that can happen is that it will make you feel better.
I doubt that it would be enough to get a drink on the house.
But I'm sure it would make you happy.
You think that sooner or later I'll give in and pour you one, right?
If I didn't know how to read people, I wouldn't be doing this job.
So you think you're good at your job?
I'm definitely not the best. I'm better than a lot of guys that hang a sign out.
Why should I offer you a drink?
Because you're not as tough as you'd like people to think. And offering a whiskey to a poor schlep like me makes you feel good in the end.
If I give you a whiskey, it's just so you'll keep your damn mouth closed. Today you're full of stupid ideas.
Well, at least I got what I wanted.
How do you want your damn whiskey?
Make it a double. No rocks. I hate watered-down whiskey. I down the first glass of whiskey in one gulp. That burn in the throat as the alcohol goes down is a thing of the past. After years of drinking, all that's left is the sweet flavor of malt. A few drinks, and my muscles start to relax. My head feels light. My vision gets cloudy. One headache later, and I'm outside the Red Tulip. Closing time, says Greta. My head is ringing like the church bells on Christmas Eve. The hammer is striking the wall of my skull like it's trying to break through. Too much whiskey, Jack. Better go home. Hello? Yeah, it's me. Well, call back tomorrow morning. I don't work at this hour. I'm not a pay-as-you-go masseuse. What? McLean? McLean's in New York? Who are you? Where did you get this information? Melville Port, in Brooklyn. Follow the Lord? What the hell does follow the Lord mean? Hello? Hello? Dannazione. He hung up. McLean. It's been years since I heard his name. Why is he in New York? I don't like this, but I have to know. I'll go to the Melville Port in Brooklyn, but I better bring my gun with me. Even if I hate carrying a gun, I don't want to take a bullet for a call from who knows who.
No i zaczyna się jakaś nowa zagadka. Zadzwonił ktoś do Jacka i powiedział, że McLean jest w mieście. McLean to jakiś chyba stary znajomy, ale no nie wiadomo, jak ta znajomość przebiegała. Stary znajomy Jacka. Tymczasem mamy tutaj takie swego rodzaju pixel hunting. Ja tego oszczędzę sobie i podświetlę. Tu są dwa miejsca interaktywne. To Dannazione jest taką cechą charakterystyczną Jacka Del Nero i akurat to jest to, co można zapamiętać z gry. Podoba mi się to Dannazione.
No, no switch here. Here's the switch.
Jesteśmy w biurze Jacka Del Nero, właściwie w jego mieszkaniu. Mieszkanie i biuro to chyba jedno i to samo u niego. Biuro ma w mieszkaniu, a mieszkanie w biurze. Co możemy tutaj ciekawego sprawdzić? O, coś tutaj jest pod drzwiami.
There's something under the door. I must have been too drunk to notice it when I got here.
Wróciłeś prawie na czworakach, co się dziwisz?
It's a letter from Slavonsky, the apartment owner.
Dear Mr. Del Nero, please remember that you are 2 months late with rent. You are asked to fulfill your duties as renter, to avoid unpleasant consequences. This is last notice that I sent. If you do not pay, I take drastic measures. Sincerely, Vladimir Alexandrovich Slavonsky.
If I had the money, I'd pay the rent. It's the third threat of eviction that this stingy Russian has sent me this month. And I think it can keep the other two company.
Zdecydowanie słychać, że autorzy starali się, by był tu słyszalny rosyjski akcent, ale też tak trochę komicznie brzmi ten słowański. No ale zostawmy ten temat. Spójrzmy tutaj. Licencja detektywa Jacka del Nero, numer 8172 z 33 roku. 27 kwietnia, 33 rok. 8172, numer licencji.
Fold-away bed, one of the best inventions in recent times.
Podoba mi się takie składane łóżko, które jest jednocześnie, można powiedzieć, szafą, bo to są półki. Fajnie to wygląda. I tu jest mnóstwo różnych rzeczy, tak zwana rupieciarnia.
A manifesto from Clito. In Calabria, the city where I was born.
Nie mam pojęcia, gdzie jest Clito i gdzie jest Calabria.
The only suitcase I have. No, I don't have any trips planned.
Dobra, szukamy pistoletu.
It's my gun holster. Dannazione. It's been years since I put the gun in here. I don't have any idea of what the combination is.
I to mi się też podoba, że kiedy wymawia Danazione, to słychać irytację w głosie. I Jack bez tego swojego ulubionego powiedzonka nie byłby tak ciekawą postacią, jak jest. Jaką jest?
My gun. My gun. It's been a while since I used it. I don't like to carry it with me. Anyway, it's not loaded, and it's pretty useless to carry it around without any bullets. I must have some bullets in my office somewhere. I just need to remember where.
Gdzie mogą być naboje? Może tutaj?
When I rented this apartment, this thing was already there. It's kind of broken, but I didn't pay for it. Here are the bullets. Let's hope they didn't rot over the years. Great. There are just three bullets. Better to be an optimist and see the magazine half full rather than half empty.
Trzy to już coś.
Good. The gun is loaded now.
Do połowy. Tylko do połowy naładowany. No i teraz wypadałoby pogadać ze Slowanskim, ale jego tutaj chyba nie ma teraz, nie widać nikogo.
Slovansky's Porter Lodge. That stingy Russian spends the whole day inside this hole. Weird he's not here now. I think this is a matryoshka. Even if from that sour expression, it doesn't look like something a kid would play with. No, I could never take it away from its natural habitat.
Wyjdźmy więc z budynku. No i pojedźmy taksówką.
Since my car is still parked in Harlem, it's the only way that I can get to Brooklyn.
Do portu.
A cab. That's just what I need.
Hi, buddy. I help you?
Take me to the Melville Port in Brooklyn.
Sorry, friend. I know in service.
What does that mean?
It means I no work. I on way. No why, no work, and no question. I on way.
I need to go to the Melville port. It's urgent.
Buddy, it's your problem, not mine. I off. If you big hurry, call cab company and have send other cab.
When is your break over?
Oh, I don't know. Can be 2 or 3 hours.
You're on a 3-hour break? What kind of nightcap are you if you take a 3-hour break in the middle of the night?
I don't talk about my work with you, especially when I am awake.
Dziwny ten taksówkarz.
Take me to the Melville port. I'll pay you twice the fare.
I don't want money. I earned big money today. And now I am awake.
Nie chcę pieniędzy.
Damn, driver. Take me to the Melville port right now.
You deaf, Paul? I off. If you big hoey, call cab company and have send other cab.
Goodbye.
You said white word. Goodbye.
Zdecydowanie kręci. Co to za taksówkarz, który robi 2 albo 3-godzinną przerwę i jeszcze nie chce podwójnej stawki? To jest wręcz niemożliwe.
New York operator, what can I do for you?
Można tutaj takie sucharowe sucharowe połączenia wykonywać z policją. Jeszcze do prezydenta Stanów Zjednoczonych można próbować zadzwonić, ale to nie jest na tyle ciekawe, by próbować.
The taxi company, please.
Coming up. Hello, Binkle Taxi. What can I do for you?
Zapłać za mnie czynsz, proszę bardzo.
I need a cab.
Where are you?
Essex Street, on the Lower East Side.
Hold, please. Are you still there?
Yes, I'm here.
I'm sorry, but the only driver in your area isn't answering his radio. He seems to have disappeared into thin air.
You don't have any other cab?
No, not right now. No one wants to work the night shift in South New York. The area is full of knuckleheads.
So the only cab available in this area is the one with this disappeared driver.
Yeah, we haven't heard from him in days. We even reported him missing to the police. But they don't care about a disappeared Mexican cab driver. They keep telling us that sooner or later, a detective will contact us by radio and they'll start an investigation. But I still haven't heard from anyone. Anyway, I can send you a cab from Harlem, but it'll still take about half an hour.
No, I can't wait. I'll figure out something else.
Okay, bye.
Ciekawe, jak Jack sobie poradzi.
All I needed was a missing cab driver. It seems that the only way to get away from here is that damn Chinese cab driver.
No to Chińczyk czy Meksykanin? Zaginiona taksówka z Meksykaninem miała być jedyną, która tutaj jeździ, natomiast jest taksówka, która nie jeździ, z Chińczykiem. Coś dziwnego tu się dzieje.
You again, buddy? I already told you, I am awake.
The company says that there are no cabs in the area.
Well, obviously, I own the cab driver in area.
Hey, wait. The receptionist said the only cab driver for this area disappeared 3 days ago.
Disappear? I know disappear. I know answer radio, that all.
And why don't you answer the radio?
I sell it, make big money.
You sold the radio?
Yes, sold. I pick up more client going round. Radio no help.
Something smells fishy.
And what do you want now?
I znów łączymy fakty. Kierowca taksówki na przerwie. Twierdzi, że to on jest tym, którego zaginięcie zgłosiła firma taksówkowa. I ta firma twierdzi, że meksykański taksówkarz pracujący w południowej części Nowego Jorku zaginął kilka dni temu.
The receptionist said the cab driver who disappeared was a fat Mexican. And you don't seem much like a fat Mexican.
I don't understand what you say.
You understand all too well if you ask me. I'm not interested in your game. But if you're Mexican, I'm Abe Lincoln.
I'm Mexican. Adopted Mexican. Lived many years in Mexico. With uncle.
Of course. And what's your uncle's name?
My uncle called Diego. Diego de la Vega.
Diego de la Vega is Zorro.
Yes, yes. His friends often call him Zorro.
He's make-believe. He doesn't exist.
What? You tell me my uncle no exists?
Let's knock it off with this story. I don't care who you are, or where you come from, or what you did with the Mexican driver. Just take me to the Melville port, and I'll keep my mouth shut about all this. Easy, right?
You blackmail me.
You can call it whatever you want. That's just how things are.
I don't listen to blackmail!
Whatever you want. I hope the police believe your story about being Zorro's Chinese nephew.
Okay. You win. You get in cab, but don't say nothing to nobody about this.
That's better.
Where we go?
The Melville Port in Brooklyn. The cab glides over Manhattan Bridge, a solitary figure ignoring the speed limit. In my head, a quartet of pneumatic hammers continues to bang on my temples, reminding me that there's still a good amount of whiskey in my veins. Not exactly the best way to go to a meeting that seems like it was set up to get rid of someone quickly.
You happy now? I bring you here and now I go away.
You're not going anywhere. Wait for me here.
I must wait you here? I don't want to wait you here. This place is scary. I want to go.
Stop whining or I swear I'll get your taxi driver's license revoked.
License? Need license to drive cab?
Great. A Chinese cab driver, without a license, who's driving the cab of some Mexican guy that nobody can find.
Welcome to New York!
Tak, lubię tego Chińczyka. Jest bardzo zabawny. Może humor w grze nie ma go zbyt dużo i nie stoi na jakimś bardzo wysokim poziomie, a akurat ten Chińczyk ma zabawne teksty. To trzeba mieć prawo jazdy, żeby jeździć taksówką? No cóż, Jack Del Nero teraz musi się mieć na baczności. Dostał dziwny telefon, no a jest jeszcze pod wpływem. Także, no musi uważać, gdzie swoje kroki stawia. Na szczęście mamy broń i 3 naboje. I zobaczymy, czy będziemy musieli zrobić z broni i z tych naboi użytek. Ale to już w kolejnym odcinku. Zobaczymy, co się tutaj w porcie wydarzy. Tymczasem na tę chwilę to już wszystko. Do usłyszenia. Pa, pa.